The day is here. I've been so excited for this day, for having the arborists come over and really clear out stuff so we can finally get our fruit trees in and get our veggie garden sorted, stuff like that. But now it's here, I'm having to do some breathing. I'm just so anxious about losing so many mature trees, especially this one that the kids like to play in. But where our veggie garden's going, that is going to be shading a lot of it. I've been checking over the last few days. The sun is still going to move as we go into summer, but I know it's for the best. We're going to plant more stuff, more oxygen-friendly stuff, bee-friendly stuff. We're going to replace things. And I need to keep saying that to myself because, oh boy, she doesn't feel good taking out mature trees. And I'm even a bit nervous about down the back. All of this will be kind of going and so much more. And they are not super mature trees. They're, I think, volunteer cherry trees, a lot of them. And we're going to get rid of the palm, which the saddest palm I'm going to be sad about getting rid of is this one just by our deck here. She's so beautiful. I don't know why it was planted right up against this part of the deck, and it's but planted in a retaining wall down there. Oh, you can't see. She's beautiful. I'm thinking I might try and get them to pull it out or leave it and we'll dig it out. But because we are going to square off this deck, she can't stay anyway. But I am going to move our, I've forgotten what it's called. I'll put the name up, and so we might move this. This can get out of here. They're not my favorite. Same with the yuccas, not my favorite. But I did notice lots of bees in this area lately. And so, oh, my little heart of getting rid of some of those, but they're so scrappy. And this is where we're gonna be planting all our fruit trees. And I'll be planting lots of bee-friendly stuff around them. The manuka is staying, so, you know, they've got that. I don't know what this pink one is here, but the bees and monarch butterflies were all over it, and oh, my little heart. But it's going to be such a huge change when I'm just such a greens, trees, nature person, so to have a lot of these taken out is hard, but I know we're going to transform this property and it's going to be for the best. So here's a last look of this part of the yard and what it's going to look like. Holy moly. Fingers crossed it all works out. The weather's not looking the best for our poor arborists today. Hopefully we'll get a bit more view once, well, no. Really it's the the neighbours' bushy trees that are getting in the road. But we do have the potential of beautiful views along here. So we'll see.
Tree.
What tree?
That tree.
This tree here that's in front, we're keeping that one.
The ones that they're cutting down. What do they need them for?
They're cutting them down so that we can have more space to do a few more things.
Like plant fruit trees?
Yep, like plant fruit trees.
Well, I bet we should plant some apples.
Yep.
And maybe some oranges?
Mm-hmm. What else?
Maybe some plums.
Okay. These guys are smashing through the work, getting all our old branches that we'd stored in that garden. Crushing probably a lot of flowers that were special. It's looking good, eh, Luca?
It's okay if we crush
flowers. No, we were crushing the flowers. They were noisy, though.
That
looks
bigger than the one that we borrowed. Why do you want to take a video?
So that people can help see, so we can see our progress, and so people can learn as we learn, essentially. No, look at all that bamboo.
We're gonna have
to. I don't
know what we're gonna do
about that. The chainsaws are really making quick work of it. It's looking really good. I'm happy with it so far, but boy, it's an adjustment. Loving all the mulch. It smells divine. Down the back. Wow. The big mulcher. Great company, very lovely men. This beastie's coming down. And all the yuckers still go. So I'm a little bit disheveled at the moment. I've just finished work, but we've had quite a bit of progress. This is the wood chippings that are left, and I know it's going to be very divisive what we've done. I know that in my heart. I know that clearing a lot of kind of scrappy trees to make place for fruit-bearing trees that we can use for ourselves, can bottle some up and share with friends and family is going to be amazing. And so that's justified. There's a couple along past where the kids are playing that I think we got rid of because they were quite unaesthetically pleasing for us and quite difficult to manage. And I think that that's where maybe I had a bit of trouble getting rid of them, but knew that it was for the best. So let's have a little look. So I showed them before. Now this is actually down that little alleyway. Oh, hey little man, you appear again down here. And it's so much bigger than I thought. This bamboo stresses me out so much. I truly hope our earthworks dear can dig out the rhizomes and that we can get on top of that. I'm not a huge fan of using poisons, as I would really like to keep things organic, but it's so invasive, and if we can't get rid of it, I don't know. If anyone's got any ideas, much appreciated. But I can walk down here confidently and with all the space in the world, oh, without tripping over the cat. It's amazing. Who knew we had, I don't know, at its widest part. I have to measure it because I've got no grasp. But like, from there to there is like, huge. Park a car. It's not as tall either. Actually, I thought this was going to be quite a hazard, and it's not ideal for a 1-year-old to fall down. The background noises have changed to happy. That's good. The amount of sun that's getting now is amazing. So now we need a stump grinder, but all of this is going to be turned into fruit trees. Holy macaroni. My hand for scale. These were yuccas, and I didn't realize how big they were. Holy moly. We've got a few volunteer trees of some description. And a cat. Meow. Oh, lots of volunteer trees. I wonder what they are. They're sharp though when you stand on them. Oh, and a volunteer cherry tree. Out. I do like cherry trees. And this tree looks pretty, but we don't need 40 of them. I wonder if anyone wants them. Oh, this is a vine. I'm gonna have to learn really quick what plants are. Golly. Okay, well. And the bamboo. So I didn't realize it was as thick as it is back here. It's on the neighbor's property. I wonder if it started there. I just don't know where it's come from. So we've kept our manuka because it's just beautiful and the bees love it. Same with the wasps, which worry me a little bit. We've kept, I don't know what that is. We've kept, forgotten the name of this, magnolia, and our Japanese maple, which is coming back to life. Looking a little sad, I may have to give her some love. The agapanthers are the next thing that we have to deal with. We're gonna keep them around, but they can be pretty invasive as well, so we're gonna have to manage them. Now it's along here that I know it's gonna be divisive because we got rid of a lot. We still have the big agapanther pile. I've actually cleared this entire pile before 2 years ago, and they came back. I knew that they would, but I didn't think it would look the exact same within that time, but it does.
The next day.
I was just heading to work this morning and I noticed, I'm not sure if you can see, let's have a look. There's steam. Oh, there. Steam coming off our mulch pile. I think she's getting pretty hot in the middle. Might need to do some research about that and if that's safe. We're still in spring and the weather's grey and damp and it is starting to spit, so we're not dry yet, but I can see how this would be a bit of a risk. And our summer, just sitting here. Cool though.